So till date, so far we have completed different concepts of work and energy. Energy especially emphasis is given on mechanical energy, and that mechanical energy is classified into two parts, the kinetic energy as well as the potential energy. Kinetic energy deals with the moving object, the energy is stored and then the work is done. And the potential energy, this depends on the configuration of the system in any field of force. And then we have discussed about the conservation of mechanical energy. So the total sum of potential energy and kinetic energy is conserved, and given different examples, the examples of a spring as well as that body. So we have different examples. That one example, when we drop one object from a particular height, then that potential energy converts into kinetic energy in different positions. And then we have also taken that the concept of a spring, the storing of energy in form of spring energy. And there we have calculated, different form of energy at different positions of that body associated with that spring. Along with this, we have also discussed that there are several forms of energy. Apart from that kinetic energy, that heat energy, electrical energy, and chemical energy, nuclear energy. So apart from that mechanical energy, we have electrical, chemical, and nuclear energies are there. So in place of conservation of mechanical energy, we can also talk about that conservation of total energy. So just the conservation of energy. So there is a separate statement for the conservation of energy. As far as that mechanical energy is concerned, that the sum of potential energy and kinetic energy is conserved in a particular system. But when we talk about the general conservation of energy, then we deal with other form of energy also. So not only that mechanical energy, but also we will include that chemical energy, electrical energy, and that nuclear energy too. So from the law of conservation of energy, statement number one, energy cannot be generated or destroyed. So that energy cannot be generated or destroyed. It converts from one form to another form in an isolated system. In any isolated system, when there is no transfer of energy, then isolated system, there is no transfer of energy from outer side. If this is that system and this is known as isolated, if it is just separated from the outer world, then within this isolated system, one energy cannot be generated or cannot be destroyed. It can only converts from one form to another form. For example, when we talk about this fan and it's moving, then there is a several form of conversion of energy. When we switch on, electrical energy is used, and that electrical energy converts into that mechanical energy in form of that rotational kinetic energy. Okay, so when we talk about an isolated system, then the energy cannot be generated or destroyed. It only converts from one form to another form. And when we talk about this universe, and we assume that this universe is as an isolated system, so in the universe, total sum of energy is constant or conserved. So in the universe, total sum of energy is constant or conserved. If we consider this universe as an isolated system. But this is for the Newtonian physics, when we talk about Newtonian physics. After Einstein's energy mass equivalent or valence. In 1905, Einstein has given one relation. E is equal to mc square. This is a very famous relation given by Einstein in 1905. This E is equal to mc square, which is known as energy mass equivalence. According to this relation, energy can be converted into mass and mass can be converted into energy. So the first statement, energy cannot be generated or destroyed. This is just changed by this relation. This E is equal to mc square means mass can be converted into energy and energy can be converted into mass. So after this relation, when we talk about this universe, the total sum of energy is conserved. This is changed. So after this relation, the total sum of mass and energy is conserved in the isolated universe. So in the universe, the total sum of mass and energy is conserved. Mass can be converted into energy, and energy can be converted into mass. And this is well used in nuclear physics. When we generate nuclear energy, then there is a concept of mass defect, and that mass defect is converted into energy using this relation. So this is the complete statement of conservation of energy, but this is for the total energy, not for the mechanical energy. For the mechanical energy, we have a single statement, the total sum of kinetic energy and potential energy is conserved. Okay, so before going into the details of transformation of energy from one form to another form, transformation of one energy to one form to another form, we should also know about one more physical parameter used in this particular chapter, energy, work, power and energy. Power is missed so far. So first of all, we should discuss about that, the concept of power. So this power, it is denoted by capital P. Small p is the momentum. This power is defined as rate of work done. So the rate of work done is power. Rate means we just think about the work in a particular time. Whenever that term rate is used, means this is just divided by time, means that work done per unit time. So R, this is work done in a particular time or per unit. So mathematically, this power, it is defined as equal to, denoted as W by T, where W is work and T is time. And by using this formula, we can deal with its unit and dimension. So the unit will be unit, generally SI unit is used. So this work is joule by this T, this is time, is second, so joule per second. So this is joule second inverse, this is also known as watt. So what is joule per second? So joule per second is also known as watt. So what is the unit of the power? And we have some bigger unit, that kilowatt, 1 kilowatt, it is equivalent to 1000 watt or 1000 joule per second. There is one more unit, that is 1 horsepower, HP, 1 horsepower, that is represented by HP, one HP, एक HP का मोटर है, two HP का मोटर, इस तरह की स्टेटमेंट दिया जाता है. So this one HP, one horse power, this is actually equivalent to 746 watt. So somewhere it is written as that power is one HP, then you have to convert it into watt, and then you have to use this. So after introducing this unit, that the unit of work, this is also written in terms of kilowatt hour. So somewhere one unit of that electricity, it is measured in unit. So one unit, that is in kilowatt hour. So that the work W, it is equivalent to P multiplied by T. So work, the unit of work can be written as equal to, this is kilowatt, and the time is taken as hour. So this kilowatt hour work done, it is used in form of unit, somewhere it is written. So first you have to convert this into watt, or that you have to convert this into joule. So 1 kilowatt is equivalent to 1000 watt, and hour is in second. So this is 1000 watt multiplied by 3600 second, 1 hour is equivalent to this, and then watt can be written as equal to joule per second. Yeah, you can. So this is equal to 3.6 into 10 to the power 6. Okay. Anyways, and also the dimension will be, dimension is this work dimension, power is equal to the dimension of work. We have taken this ML2 T minus 2 volts multiplied by displacement upon this time, this is T. So this is equal to ML square T minus 3. This is the dimension formula of power. Now the transfer of energy from one body to another body. So generally the transfer is due to the physical contact. So we will talk about another topic of this chapter, that is collision of one body to another body. So through collision, energy is transformed from one body to another body. So if we have a volumetric box and there is a gas molecules, then one molecule collides with another molecule and energy is transformed. And even that in case of heat energy transformation, the collision can be considered in a microscopic level. So this collision, this is just the collision of two bodies, and there are two or more bodies. So this is classified into two parts. Categorized into, one is elastic collision and second one is inelastic collision. So collisions are classified into two parts, elastic collision and inelastic collision. So we will use all physical parameters with this. In this elastic collision, first we have several points. First one is linear momentum is conserved. So linear momentum is conserved. What it means? The total momentum before collision is equal to the momentum after collision. Total energy, it is also conserved. Total energy is conserved. So you have to remember all these points. Momentum is conserved, linear momentum is conserved, and the total energy is conserved, as well as the kinetic energy of the system. Kinetic energy is also conserved. So the sum of kinetic energy, potential energy, or the sum of the total energy, it is conserved when we take different form. And the kinetic energy is separately, it is conserved. Fourth one is, the force is in general, conservative. And fifth point, there is no energy loss. So in this collision, there is no energy loss in form of heat, etc. So there is no energy loss in elastic collision. Okay, so these are five important points for this elastic collision. First, linear momentum is conserved, total energy is conserved, and kinetic energy is conserved, as well as the force considered is generally conservative force, and there is no energy loss at all. So now let's write some more points in this. First, linear momentum is conserved in this case also. So the linear momentum is conserved. First point is asceptance. Second, the total energy is also conserved. Total energy is conserved. Third, kinetic energy is not conserved. Kinetic energy is not conserved. Not conserved means there will be energy loss. So there is kinetic energy loss. So there is kinetic energy loss. So if kinetic energy is not conserved, then there is a kinetic energy loss. Fourth, force is mostly non-conservative. So the force is mostly non-conservative. And obviously, the kinetic energy is not conserved, means there will be energy loss. So fifth point one can write, there is energy loss. So if you want to consider that our daily life observation in this case, then we can think about that game of billiard ball game. One ball collides with another ball, and that second ball moves according to the first one. Just we can think about that striking of that carom board game. So collides with another one. So we will have different type of collision, that elastic collision if there is no energy loss, and if there is some energy loss, then that will be inelastic collision, where the kinetic energy is not conserved, it is converted in form of in general heat, and the force used is non-conservative, whereas the linear momentum, total energy, kinetic energy, all these are conserved in case of like elastic collision, and the forces in general used as conservative force. So now we'll try to derive some formula for that these two cases. So the first we will consider about elastic collision. So we have in that elastic collision, we have one body of mass m1. Initially, it's moving with velocity u1. And there is another body somewhere here of mass m2, which is moving with initial velocity u2. Obviously, if this u2 is greater than u1 is greater than u2, after some time, this m1 collides with this. So, after time t, this collides. This is the collision. This is m1, this is m2. And after collision, its velocity changes, and now this object, this is m1 moving with initial velocity v1, and the second object, that is m2, moving with the final velocity, and that final velocity v2. Okay, so this is that mass m1, this is another mass m2, and these are initially moving with a velocity u1 and u2 respectively. After collision, its velocity becomes v1 and v2 respectively. So momentum will be, its momentum will be m1 u1, its momentum will be m2 u2, its after collision its momentum will be m1 v1 and this is m2 v2. As per the kinetic energy is concerned, that initial kinetic energy is equivalent to half k, half m1 u1 square, its kinetic energy is half m2 u2 square, and after collision its kinetic energy is equal to half v1 k square, and this is half m2 v2 square. Because this is elastic collision, so in the elastic collision the momentum is conserved, linear momentum is conserved, as well as kinetic energy is conserved. So from the conservation of momentum, we can take that initial momentum is equal to that initial momentum is equal to final momentum of the system. So the initial momentum is this, and this is m1 u1 plus m2 u2. This is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2, which can be rewritten. It is equal to that m for the first body and for the second body. So this m1 u1 minus m1 v1, it is equal to m2 v2 minus m2 u2. This is equation number 6. So first we have written this equation for the separate system. Now just we have separated out it for the first body, and this is for the second body. This is for the mass m1, this is for the mass m2. Now from the conservation of kinetic energy, so the initial kinetic energy of the system is equal to the final kinetic energy of the system. So this is equal to half m1 u1 square plus half m2 u2 square. This is equal to half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. And similarly, we can write this for the separate body. So one can have, this is equal to half m1 v1 square minus half m2 v2 square, m1 u v1 square, and this is equal to half m2 v2 square minus half m2 u2 square. So just I am transferring this to this and this to this, and one can write this is equal to half m1, and this is v1 square minus v1 square, and this is equal to half m2 v2 square minus u2 square, and one can write this is equal to half m1 u1 v1 and u1 plus v2. This is equal to half m2 v2 minus u2 and v2 plus u2. Similarly here one can write this is equal to m1 u1 minus v1, this is equal to m2 v2 minus u2. This is equation number 2, and this is equation number 3. Yes, how can we cancel? Just cancel this out. So now let's divide this equation number 3 by equation number 2. by dividing equation number 3 by equation 2. So that is M1 U1 minus V1 multiplied by U2 plus V2 by here. This is M1 U1 minus V1. This is equal to M2, this is V2 minus U2 multiplied by V2 plus U2 by M2. This is multiplied by V2 minus U2. So just cancel out. U1 V1. So that is again to U1 plus V1 is equal to U2 plus V2. This is equal to U1 minus U2, that is equal to V2 minus V1. So by using this relation and the equation number 2, we can calculate U1 and U2. So from here, from this equation, we can calculate it for U2, that is equal to U1 plus V1 minus V2 into equation 2, I think. Equation number 2 or 3, this one conservation of momentum, and that conservation of momentum relation is into any of the relation that M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to M1 E1 plus M2 V2. So here when we put this value of U2 and solve it for U1, one can get U1 in terms of V2 equal to U1 or U2. U1 U2, we have to calculate V2. ये बीच बीच में ना जो डिस्टर्ब होता है ना वो बड़ा मैथमेटिकल कैलकुलेशन का डर रहता है. फर्स्ट वी हैव टू एक्चुअली आफ्टर वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट V1 एंड V2. U1 एंड U2 इज गिवन. सो V1 एंड V2 कैलकुलेट करना है मींस दैट वी विल वी हैव टू सॉल्व फॉर दिस V2. सो दिस इंप्लाइज V2 इज इक्वल टू U1 माइनस U2 प्लस V1. बाय पुटिंग दिस बाय this into M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. This is the relation. We put this V2 here and solve it for V1. So after solving, you can solve this. So after doing mathematics, after solving, you can solve this, and V1 is equal to M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2 multiplied by U1 plus 2M1 by M1 plus M2, this is M2 multiplied by U2. So when you put this here and solve it for V1, then you have this relation in terms of U1 and U2 and the mass M1 and M2. And also by putting this value of this V1 here, and you can solve for V2. And similarly for V2, you can derive this. Simple mathematics is there. And after doing mathematics, you will have this relation M1, M2 and this. And for V2,
वो वाला इक्वेशन उसमें डालने के बाद हुआ है.
हाँ, you have to put this V2, V2 you have to put here and solve it for V1. So the answer will be in terms of U1, U2 and that M1 and M2, and the answer will be this. So simple mathematics is there. Just you have to transfer one parameter to second side like that. And similarly, you can get that V2, and for V2 you have to solve it for V1 and put the value here and calculate it. and after calculation, the result will be just you have to interchange this m1 and m2 in this expression. So that relation is equivalent to m2 minus m1. So in place of m1, you have to place m2. And this m2, you have to place m1. And this is upon m1 plus m2. And this is u1. They are probably same. Just after replacing it, this is with plus sign, so there will be no change. And this is plus 2m1 by m1 plus m2 multiplied by. Okay, so let's have one overview of the calculation or the this concept. So we have taken two bodies and just considering that elastic collision. So we will consider that the conservation of momentum and conservation of kinetic energy. So the conservation of momentum and conservation of kinetic energy for the same system, for the complete system, and then we calculate it for the single body, left hand side and right hand side, and just by dividing that equation number 3 and equation number 2, we will get this relation. And after just getting this relation, we have solved it for V2 and put into that conservation of momentum and get this relation. And you have to calculate V2, then we have to solve it for V1. We have to solve it for V1, and by putting that into that the same equation, we will get this relation. So this is for V1 and V2. Now we can consider some special cases. Some special cases by using this relation. So just so as a parent relation, we have this V1 it is equivalent to M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2 multiplied by U1 plus 2M2 by M1 plus M2 multiplied by this U2, and this V2 this is equivalent to M2 minus M1 by M1 plus M2 U1 plus 2M1 by M1 plus M2 multiplied by U2. This is the parent relation. Now some special cases. Case number 1. If both body are equal mass, so M1 is equivalent to M2. That is equivalent to M1. If both bodies have equal mass, then this V1 is equal to, this is 0. This is 0. And put M1 is equal to M, and this is also equal to M. So this is V1, it is equal to U2. Okay, so just put M1 is equal to M2 is equal to M. So this is 0, and this is 2M upon 2M. So that V1 is equal to U2. And in the second equation, again this is 0. So this is V2, it is equal to U2, this is U2, this is U1. Script, subscripts ko change karna tha. So after changing subscripts, in place of that 1, we are just taking as 2. So this is M2, M1. So this is M2, M1. This is M1, M2, so identical. So 1 is converted into 2. So this, when we take this, M1 is equal to M2, then that V1 is equivalent to U2 and V2 is equivalent to U1. What it means? This is 0, so this is equivalent to U1. इसका मतलब ये हो रहा है कि velocity interchange हो जाता है. दो body है, दोनों का mass अगर कोई equal है. If this body is moving with 30 meter per second and this is moving with 40 meter per second. If mass is equal, then after collision, its velocity will be 40 meter per second, its velocity will be 30 meter per second. इंटरचेंज हो जा रहा है. सो वेलोसिटी ऑफ बॉडीज आफ्टर कोलिजन इंटरचेंज. केस नंबर टू इफ M1 it is equivalent to M2 is equivalent to M. Both are identical. And second body is M2 is at rest. Second body jo hai, wo rest mein hai. Second body rest mein, iska matlab kya ho raha hai? That U2 फील्ड इज अप्लाइड टू जीरो. Put the value in this case so that V1 is equal to U2 is 0. This is 0. So here this will be also 0. So that V1 is equivalent to 0. Means first body rest mein aa jayega. As far as that mathematics is concerned, we are taking this U2 is 0 because that second body is at rest. That this body is moving with velocity U and this body is at rest. After collision, this will be at rest and this will move with a constant velocity. We can calculate that V2 it is equal to this is 0 now and this is equal to U1. Mass is identical, just you have to put M1 is equal to M2 is equal to M and velocity V2 is equal to U2 is equal to 0. Then this will be 0 and this will be 0 and this is 0. So the first body will be at rest and second body will move with a constant velocity. Again this case is same. Here the velocity is interchanging, here also the velocity is interchanging. Second body was at rest, so the first body was will be at rest and second body will move with the constant velocity of first body. Okay, so now third case is when M1 is much greater than M2, when the first body is a bigger body, a massive body, and M2 is at rest, means U2 it is equal to 0. So this is one big body moving with initial velocity U1, and this is that small body that is M2 and M1, and this collides with this. This is that U2 is equal to 0. Okay, so in this expression, since M1 is greater than M2, so this M1 plus M2, this we will take, this M1 plus M2, it is nearly equal to taken as equivalent to M1. Okay, दोनों को जोड़ दिए, है ना? जोड़ने के बाद चूंकि इसको neglect करना पड़ेगा, that is nearly equal to M1, and U2 is just you can check that U2 is equivalent to 0, and obviously that M1 minus M2 this is also equivalent to M1. हम second वाले को लगा सकते हैं. So just forget about M2. M2 को 0 को बराबर ले लो ऐसा मान के चलो. With compared to M1. Okay. So this is just a 0. This term will be 0. So one can think this M2 can be taken as nearly equal to 0 in this expression. Body बड़ा है तो M2 को हम nearly equal to 0 ले लें और इस expression में उसको solve करते चले जाएं. U2 को नेक्स्ट केस हम ले सकते हैं रिवर्स ऑफ दिस. इफ दिस M1 इज लेस देन M1 इज स्मॉलर बॉडी एंड दिस M2 इज अ बिगर बॉडी, सो दिस M2 इज ग्रेटर देन M1 एंड स्टिल दैट U2 इज जनरली सेकंड बॉडी इज टेकन एज रिजल्ट. सो वी विल हैव डिफरेंट स्पेशल कंडीशंस टू सॉल्व अ न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम एंड द पेरेंट्स इक्वेशन इज दिस. सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस टू इक्वेशंस. ओके, सो दिस इज M1 माइनस M2 बाय दिस U1 टू M1. Maximum numerical problems of collision, if that collision is elastic collision, can be solved by using this. These are the different conditions. Conditions may be some more conditions can be included also. Special cases may be included also. Okay, so in the next class we will talk about inelastic type collision and that energy loss due to that inelastic collision. And for today, I think this is more than enough. Thank you.